The stream. Hello guys, welcome back to the stream. Hope you have watched all the previous episodes of the mining sessions. So this will be about the proper mining build. I've discussed already. If you are not seeing the video, this is the card there on the upper hand, left or right side, which I don't know, it will come on the left side, I guess. You can watch it. So today in this particular video, we are going to do proper mining. You're using a proper mining gear, how to set up your system once you have built it. So which OS you should choose, regarding those things we will discuss today. It will be fun. I'll try to keep as short as possible. Guys, sorry, but stay with me. So let's begin. So before that, please press subscribe. Do share if you like the video among your colleagues. Thank you. Hello guys, so I just made a small text document for you guys to understand what to choose and which OSs to select. So basically, we right now the most widely used OS is Windows 10, especially after the LHR and LHR unlock issues. So Windows 10 apps has proven to be quite useful, but the same can be used in HiOS Linux as well. Windows 10, the best thing is that you can do multitasking as I am doing right now, which is not possible with other OSs, especially with HiOS. You can only just mine. For example, right now I have two mining going on background. Like I have one card mining Kapo, the other one mining Octopus. So everything is running in background, and on, as you can hear the music, it is also playing. I'm web browsing in between. So everything is happening. So this is possible with Windows 10 only. And Windows 10 has become more and more stable, but the thing is that even now there are crashes, and recently I found out that crashes happen very often. So it is related to overclocks. So be careful when you do overclocking. It's best to leave it at what it is. If you don't know what you're doing, that we'll come to in a bit. So basically, you water mine. Let's keep water mine. Then the second thing you need is an overclock software. Use MSI Afterburner, which is a very good software. This is MSI Afterburner. So it has different clock settings which you can set, different profiles which you can save. For example, by default, this will be the default settings. So I've actually saved 5 different clock settings for my different 2 cards. So this is default settings now. So if I select one of this, it will overclock automatically. I've set different clock settings for different coins, so I can choose one of this. So this is for one card, and for the other one, I've set this one. So these are like different clock settings which I use for different mining process. So this Afterburner is a very handy tool. And once you get the hang of the proper mining, so algorithms, there are certain codes which you can enter into the bat file, which if you manage to do that by yourself, you don't need this MSI burner Afterburner at all. You can set everything in respective mining software. So keeping that mind, I will post a link to the Afterburner, but you can Google it, which is the easiest way. So next is TT miner or T-Rex miner or NB miner, whichever miner you want to choose, you can choose. But the important thing is you download the miners from legit websites. I am posting a GitHub link for everything in here. And then you have the NiceHash miner. I'm not talking about the Qt miner. I'm talking about the desktop mining software called NiceHash miner, which looks somewhat like this. You can install it. You can go to the website and download it. So basically what it does is it does overclocking, all those things by itself. And it is quite good. It will do the benchmarking for you guys. So this is how it works. So this is currently a fully benchmarked update, and you can see how much mega hashes you can obtain for each cards in each algorithm. So this is quite good, and this is somewhat very very accurate because NiceHash is quite accurate in these areas. Okay, there are drawbacks and usabilities also. So this is how it comes, and you can just press play. It will start mining. Right now I won't do that because already mine is mining using T-Rex miner. So it will stop there. Then comes the important part. You can download it or whatever you want, but your system won't let you install it unless and until you make it safe. So the problem with that is most of the antiviruses will detect all the minor software and related files as virus. So you want to either uninstall the antivirus, which is not a safer option, but it is required in most scenarios, especially when you are changing, updating and all, you have to every now and then change the folders and settings and all. The easiest way is to uninstall it. Right now, my system, I believe it is okay with Windows Defender. Windows Defender, yeah. Type Windows Security in the search, go there. Select virus threat and protection. In this, come down, select virus threat protection, manage settings. Before installing anything, turn this real-time protection off, okay? And then go down, select exclusions. You, wherever you have unpacked your files, mine is set in desktop, so add an inclusion, select folder, and you can choose whichever folders you want to exclude. Select each one by one and select the folder. So it will exclude it from being detected as a virus or something like that, and then turn on the real-time protection. This is a must step you should, everyone should do, and don't forget this. Okay guys, that's what all matters. So once you installed it, then now comes the part which going to mine. So right now, for single GPU setup like mine, like I have two GPUs. One is a 4GB RAM, VRAM version of 1050 Ti, which I can only mine Kapow algorithm, which is the only profitable coin right now. Then I have another graphics card, which is a 3060 RTX, which is the LHR version, for which I can mine multiple coins, whichever I like, feel like. So in the beginning, I was mining exclusively Raven coin. And once the LHR unlock came, I tried my hands on mining mining Dagger Hashimoto. I was able to get up to 31.5 hash rate, mega hashes in Dagger Hashimoto, which is actually an acceptable hash rate after the LHR unlock. How to do LHR unlock and how to configure TRX miner is coming next. I can't include all those things in this video, so I'll just go keep it to the basics right now. So this is the thing, guys. So my choice of operating system will be Windows 10 even now, and then download MSI Afterburner for the time being. And among these miners, I found out that TRX miner is the most stable miner in terms of shares accepted, rejections, connections and all those things. Now comes the next part. If you have an antivirus, uninstall it. If you don't want it, uninstall an antivirus program, buy a separate hard disk, format it, install Windows 10, update it to the maximum recent updates, enable Windows Defender in that, and mine on that hard drive, not the one which you're using for regular use. You can switch in between, like if you're generally while mining, the problem is that it is quite difficult to play games or do other high memory bandwidth applications. So basically it is useless. So right now, my advice will be Windows 10, remove the antivirus, put Windows Defender, keep it updated, that's enough. So that's the thing. Another important disclaimer is download miners from legit website. Even though these things are supposed to be safe, anyone can put a code on these bad files and screw with you guys. So mining is a risky business. It's up to you guys. You need two more things. One is you need a wallet. Depending upon different number of coins, different types of coins, you can use different wallet. For example, ETH, Bitcoin, you have Raven, you have Conflex. So all these things come with different wallet setups. None of these coins can be stored in the same wallet except for Ethereum and Bitcoin. which you can use these trading applications like Binance or WazirX in India. You can actually directly deposit your coins into that. But the problem is that when you deposit coins into such kind of wallets, the gas fees will be higher. So you should choose another random wallet, good free wallet. I've been using for Conflex, I've been using a wallet called Phlox. It's a desktop wallet. It is very secure and it is quite user friendly as well. And for Raven, I've been using a wallet called Trust Wallet, which is an Android application. You can search, Google it, Trust Wallet. For Ethereum and BTC, there are so many wallet options available. Select any wallet which is free and supports both. Okay, guys. So this is the thing. Other than these four coins, I didn't mine anything else. So I can't guide you on those things because those other coins are not profitable right now. Even Ergo, Sphero and all, I'm not trusting with profitability. Then comes the second most important thing. It is selecting the pools. So pool selection is quite important in the sense like giving your geographical location, your ISP routing and all those things. You might have to select a pool which is having the lowest ping rate. So you can check the ping rates using a different method. You can just Google mining pool ping status, or for selecting a particular mining pool, you can use this website called miningpoolstatus.stream. So I have it here always pinned into my website. So right now this is a current status of mining 2-. So Ravencoin 2-, is the best pool right now. But remember, they have a different kind of pay per last number of share system. So payout is little bit less, but the minimum payout is 10 coins. From my experience, guys, for Ravencoin 2- is the best. Their payout is Paka. If you mine a full day using my 30x60 LHR card plus my 1050 Ti, I'm easily getting around 30 mega hashes, and I'm getting somewhere between 25 to 30 Raven coins every day. So that is quite good. And it is fixed. It doesn't change much. Like variability is between 25 to 30. That's it. Meanwhile, other sites are also there like flypool.org. So I'll show you flypool.org status, and I'll also show my Raven status with 2-. So this is my Raven account with 2-. You can see so far I have made around 491 total coins. So when you consider the shares and all, the reward ratio and all, it's quite good. So this is because I didn't mine the whole day, but it is standard. It is quite good. Payouts are regular, interval payouts will be there. Like you can get up to 3 payouts a day. So that's quite good. Okay, so that's it, guys. So like you can choose the pool depending upon your choice. All pools pay somewhat the same. So I tried the second best pool in the this thing called flypool.org. Their 24-hour earning was quite low, maybe because I didn't set it properly. But I found out everything has similar payout strategies. So this also pays around 10 coins per day. And stay away from some pools which offer like a lesser number of coins as payout, because invariably these things sucks. So my choice for Ravencoin will be 2- and flypool.org. Other coins like you can Ethereum and all, you can search here. Ethereum, select Ethereum. Then it will show the largest pool by mega hashes here. So Spark Pool is a PPS plus type one, but the payout, I don't know, guys. I have never mined Ethereum, so I can't say for sure whether it is good or bad. But I've been reading some reviews. Ethermine.org is supposed to be very good, but you can try for yourself and see. Okay. Then the next coin I mined was Conflex, and I'm still mining the Conflex coin. So Conflex coin, according to them, okay, new coin, new group have come up. That is Pool Flare. This was not there a couple of days back. They have actually have now better than Bpool. Earlier Bpool was the best pool, but I am using Nanopool. Nanopool payouts are quite easy, and I'm getting around, and there is no payout fees. So this is my CFX mining pool. So as you can see here, I'm getting good payouts, good number of shares as well, and it is quite good. I've already got around 6 Conflexes within 2 days mining hours, 2 mining hours, and in between I've taken a break. So then that's there. So you can choose your pool, whichever pool you want, you can choose depending upon the coin you're mining. And currently, according to Watermine, if you have an RTE 3060 unlocked card like mine, these are the most profitable coins. So my advice for all of you guys who are just starting mining will be to install NiceHash Miner. So guys, NiceHash is a very good miner software. It has a very good dashboard system in which you can control all the mining applications. And it does have an Android and iOS application which you can download from the Play Store or iOS Store. So with which you can either start or stop your rig if you have enabled a remote control. Otherwise, you have to use some software called TeamViewer or something similar if you want to control your rig. So that's one thing. Then, and second advantage of NiceHash is it pays in Bitcoin, and you can convert Bitcoin to any other coin of your choice whenever you want. If I want to buy any other particular coin which has a quite large list of coins which you can buy and keep it, because on the long run this can fetch you more money than Bitcoin in some scenarios, fingers crossed. This is no financial advice anyway. So that is it. There are disadvantages as well, because you will be getting only payment in this thing, Bitcoin. And if you consider the average payment ratios, like if you get $4 worth income using T-Rex miner while Kapow mining, the same thing using NiceHash, you will be getting somewhere between 3.5 only. That's one issue which I found out. So 24 hour mining, maybe it's because of different days which I mined. Like even some YouTubers have pointed out the same problem. So if that doesn't bother you much, you want hassle-free mining, put it into NiceHash. It will benchmark your graphics card, whatever card you have, and it will mine the most profitable coins at that moment of time, and will give you the payments in Bitcoin, and which of course you can use Bitcoin to buy something else. So, and the winner is NiceHash for single GPU mining. For multi GPU mining, you can use any other miners. So that's it, guys. Thank you. Stay tuned for more. Do press the like button. If you have liked the video, please share it.